Hello everyone, I say Noah Zay. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in today's video we are going to see the properties of crude oil. Okay, so let us quickly see the content for today's presentation. So as you can see that in my previous video we have discussed the properties of crude oil, which are nothing but density, specific gravity and API gravity. And apart from API gravity, we have also seen the Bauma series. Okay, so in today's video we are going to see about gas solubility. Right, so let us quickly jump for gas solubility definition. So the definition is like, first of all, it is represented by R to the base S, okay, and it is defined as you can see, in general, if I want to say that amount of gas which is dissolved in crude oil, okay. So this is the proper definition, this is a general definition. So if you want to read it out, the definition is like, the ratio of number of standard cubic feet of gas which is dissolved in one stock tank barrel. Okay, so that you have to keep in mind that it should be one stock tank barrel of a crude oil. So within that, how much gas is dissolved, that is said to be a gas solubility. Okay, and if you want to see the mathematical representation of this RS, gas solubility, it is defined as RS is equals to volume of gas which is evolved from oil as pressure decreases and divided by the volume of produced oil following gas evolution. Okay, so after the gas has been evolved, how much volume of oil has been produced, so that is considered to be in denominator. So the ratio of this both is nothing but your gas solubility, and the unit of gas solubility, as you can see over here, that is nothing but SCF per STB. Okay, so apart from this, you even have to note one thing, that this both the units are volumetric units. This is standard cubic feet and this is stock tank barrel. Okay, so let us quickly see what is our next slide. So here, if you see this diagram, okay, let us consider this P2 as the initial reservoir pressure, and let us consider this as reservoir. So as you can see over here, that this blue color, if you consider this as in water, or you can consider this as oil. So at initial reservoir condition, you can see that the gas, these bubbles are nothing but the gas bubbles, or this is a gas which is dissolved in water. So as the pressure decreases from initial reservoir pressure to certain level, or gradually decreasing pressure leads to the evolution of gas from oil or water, whatever you consider this blue region as. Either you can consider as oil or you can consider it as water. Okay, so as you can see over, the condition is like, as the pressure reduces, the gas will evolve from oil. Okay, so let us see the graphical representation of this gas solubility. As you can see that y-axis represents the RS, nature of RS, and this x-axis is nothing but the pressure of a reservoir. Okay, so here you can see one thing, that P to the base B, this is nothing but your bubble point pressure. So this bubble point pressure plays very important role in a reservoir. So as the reservoir pressure reaches the bubble point pressure, so at that particular point the gas will start to evolve from oil. Okay, so if you see that up to bubble point pressure, let us consider this pressure here over here is like 1800. So it is starting from 1800, when it reaches to 1600 over here. Okay, so up to this point there is no change in the volume of RS. Okay, means up to this point there is no change in the volume of gas. Okay, so let us consider this pressure is starting from bubble point pressure to 1600 pressure, what we have seen in the graph. Okay, right, so after this, if you see the gas within the oil after bubble point pressure is gradually decreasing. Okay, So what I mean to say over here is like the gas solubility will get decreased within the oil if the reservoir pressure reaches the bubble point pressure. Okay, up to bubble point pressure there is no change in the volume. And you can see in another way that the zone of gas which we called as gas cap. Okay, so how much gas cap volume has been increased if there is a decrease in pressure after bubble point. So if you see that kind of graph, then it will be in this manner. So that graph will be in, first of all it will be at constant volume up to the reservoir pressure reaches the bubble point pressure, then after that it will gradually increase. This scenario I'm talking in terms of the volume of a gas cap. Okay, and this scenario is like the volume of gas within the oil. Okay, so I hope you understood these two scenarios. So that's an end for today's video. If you have any so these are the references what I have used. Okay, like LPTech, Tariq Ahmed, AI Levinson. Okay, so that's an end for today's video. If you have any kind of queries, then you can use my comment box, or else you can mail me up at nawaz.delta.au@gmail.com. And apart from that, if you like this video, then hit like, share, comment and subscribe to my YouTube channel Petroleum Universe. And if you haven't subscribed my channel, then subscribe it. And please press the bell icon to receive a latest notification of my videos. Thank you so much. That's an end. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.